Dear Lady Love TV.
Billionaire's Dark Secret.
Tunghayan po natin ang huling kabanata ng ating kwento. Pumayag si Hailey sa kasunduang iyon hindi lamang dahil sa gusto niyang matulungan ang kumpanya. Dahil gusto niyang patunayan na iba na ang kanyang pagkatao. Na mayroon siyang magagawa. Na kahit pinili ang ibang tao ng kanyang mga magulang, lalo na ng kanyang ama, iniwan siya ng kanyang ama sa kanyang tiya Sela at sa bahay nito dahil sumama ito sa kanyang stepmother. The other side of her personality, the bad side dictates her to take revenge. Punong-puno ng galit ang kanyang puso. But the other side of her personality, which is good, dictates her to help her father because she is still her father even though she abandoned her when she was a child. Nalilito si Hailey sa mga pagkakataong ito. Makalipas ang ilang oras. Matapos niyang pagtalunin ang dalawang personalidad na mayroon siya, nanalo ang negatibong parte ng kanyang pagkatao. Handa siyang maging isang masamang tao. Hailey slowly walks in front of the mirror. She decided to reveal her real physical appearance. She removed the dye on her hair. She removes her makeup that makes her look Asian woman. Matapos gawin iyon, ay nakita ang totoong siya. Lalo siyang gumanda. When she was satisfied with her looks, she decided to go outside again even though it's already evening. Pumunta siya sa kabayanan. Doon siya kumain ng hapunan sa isa sa mga sikat na restaurant na naroon sa loob ng bayan. She is about to enter the restaurant when a stranger bumps on her head. She nearly slips on the floor. Her feet slide accidentally and she loses her balance, but the stranger managed to hold her. Hailey was so annoyed. She turns around to start a fight, but she gets surprised when she sees the man who bumped her. Alfie? Wika nito. Alfie lets go of her arms. Nakangiti lang ito. What are you doing here? Tanong ni Alfie. Tumaas lang ang kilay ng dalaga. What do you think? Sagot nito. Instead of answering Alfie's question, Alfie holds Hailey's hand and leads her inside the restaurant. To avoid creating a scene, Hailey just obeyed. Alfie chooses a table good for two at the corner of the restaurant. Tinawagan niya ang waiter at umorder sila ng pagkain samantalang naiwang tahimik lamang si Hailey. Pinagmamasdan nito ang ginagawa ni Alfie. Hailey noticed that Alfie is really attractive, even he just wear an ordinary shirt and jeans. Alfie is wearing a black shirt that fits on his semi-muscular body. Alfie likes fashion too. Wearing ripped jeans make him fashionable and stylish. The ripped jeans that he is wearing add more charm and coolness in his personality, as well as his shoulder length, dark semi-curly hair that curled prettily around his face. Nang maihanda ng pagkain, Alfie puts some food on Hailey's plate, then on his own plate. Pinapanood lang siya ni Hailey sa kanyang ginagawa habang nakataas ang mga kilay. Sige na, tara na kumain. Stop raising your eyebrow at me, wika ng binata. Sige, Hailey said, then get her spoon and fork. Alfie is about to put some foods again on Hailey's plate but Hailey stops him by hitting his hand with her spoon. Ouch! Bakit mo ginawa yon? Sagot ng binata. Tama na. I had too much food on my plate. Gusto mo bang tumaba ako? Sagot ng dalaga. Natawa lang si Alfie sa sinabi nito. You're on a diet? Don't worry. Even you became fat, it is for sure you will still have a husband. Haley was surprised to hear those words from Alfie. Kahit sino, pwede kang pakasalan. You already knew about that? Haley asked. Yeah, even the date. My grandfather told me. Alfie answered while his gaze fixed on Haley's beautiful face. Haley just ignored his action and started eating her food. Sobrang ganda ni Haley sa kanyang paningin. Sobrang ganda mo, lalo na ngayon na nakita ko yung totoong itsura mo, wika ni Alfie. Nagpatuloy lang si Haley sa pagkain at nagkukunwaring hindi naririnig ang kahit anong sinasabi ng binata. Then after a few minutes, Haley decided to ask Alfie if he knew who the guy that she is about to marry. For sure, Alfie knew because he is one of the board directors of RNA Summit Holdings. Alfie, do you know who the guy that I'm about to marry? My father still didn't know who he was. He is still waiting for advice coming from your grandfather, sagot ni Haley. Yes, very well, sagot ni Alfie. Who is he? Here, in front of you, sagot ng binata. You mean you are the one? Nagtatakang wika ni Haley. Yes, I am, sagot ng binata. Kahit hindi sigurado ay naglakas loob si Haley na sabihin kay Alfie ito. Alfie, after our marriage, can you please allow me to go back to Asian country? And please, let's just remain friends. Wika ni Haley. But he is determined enough not to let her go again. So, he take all his courage to say these words to her. Why can't it be? Why can't it be the two of us? Why can't it be that we can't be lovers? Only friends, sagot ni Alfie. Napatungo lamang si Haley at napatingin sa kanyang plato. Nananahimik. Her psychological condition is the main reason. Her emotion is always splitting. It takes a few minutes before she answers Alfie's question. Because I know I'm only hurting you. I know I'm always making you cry. Maybe you're right when you said that I need a psychiatrist. I don't want to become your burden for a lifetime. All of my past relationships failed, end up in breakup. I'm a very difficult person to be with. I can't control myself most of the time, doing things that makes other people annoy. Also, I don't want to fall in love with you because I don't want to get hurt anymore. I'm fed up having been into a relationship and failed. All the relationships partners that I had before left me all alone. Sagot ni Haley. Don't worry, Haley. Just for a chance to be with you, I'll take the risk at all. Don't be afraid to fall in love with me because I will never leave you until the end. I know how to keep my promises. I know how to keep them well. You really knew me at all. We can share the laughters and the pain. I will never leave you alone, so please don't go. Say you'll never go. Please. Pagsusumamo ni Alfie. Hindi makasagot si Haley. Umiiyak lang ito. Hindi niya mapigilan ang mga luhang tumutulo sa kanyang mga mata. Alfie knows that the meaning of that silence is and crying. She is determined to leave him again no matter what he does. But this time, Alfie doesn't want to let her go again. So he decided to use all the power and authority that he has because it seems that Haley won't listen to his plea. This time, she speaks to Haley with authority and threat. Look, stop making drama. We are in a public place. Let's get into a business. It's clear on the agreement that it is signed by your father that you will marry me in exchange of the funds that he got to save his company. And if he didn't fulfill what is asked in the agreement, his company will be taken by RNA Summit Holdings. And this will be given to the other business partners to manage. In short, the ownership with his own company will be terminated. That means he will totally lose his company. And I know your father can't afford losing his company. I'm just sticking to what is written on the agreement and to the policy. Alam na alam nilang lahat ang nilalaman ng kasunduang iyon. Muling pagpapaliwanag ni Alfie. Haley didn't say anything. So Alfie asked her this question. Haley, do you understand? Alfie asked with a frown in his face. But Haley just remained silent. Haley raises her eyes to look into Alfie's face. Then she answers him. Fine, I will marry you by then just to save my father's company. Saad nito, "Good. It's late at night. I'll drive you home now." Lunes, sa R&A Perfume Company, the company was officially open. Alfie got so busy supervising the company while Haley started working on the production area. When Haley's shift ends, Alfie fetches her. He promised to drive her home. Haley sees that Alfie seems so tired. Pareho na silang napapagod. Kaya hindi na sila halos nag-uusap kahit magkasama pa sila sa sasakyan. Nung makarating sila sa unit ni Haley, Alfie immediately set the food that he bought on the table. Then without talking to each other, sabay silang kumain. Makatapos kumain, Haley was expecting that Alfie will go home, but she hears Alfie said, "I will sleep here tonight." Wika nito, "Fine," sagot ni Haley habang nagtaas ng kilay. When their eyes met, Haley raised her eyebrow while Alfie just showed his sweetest smile. Hanggang sa lumipas pa ang marami mga araw, ganito ang palagi nangyayari sa kanilang dalawa. Alfie will fetch Haley after work and drive her home. Then he sleeps in Haley's apartment from time to time. Kapag Sabado at Linggo, they go out for a date. Alfie's birthday came. During Alfie's birthday party, Hamilton officially announced the official date of Alfie and Haley's wedding. After the announcement, the dinner was served. Then, when the dinner was over, they began to dance. Especially the visitors who are couple dance in a sweet music. Alfie is too good-looking in his formal attire. Guapo at kaakit-akit ang kanyang itsura. While Haley is wearing a light purple-pink evening gown, sobrang ganda niyang tingnan at bumata ang kanyang edad. Haley feels too bored at the party. Sobrang daming bisita na hindi naman niya kilala. She got even so annoyed because there are many women who show their interest in Alfie even though they knew that Alfie and her are about to get married. Haley just finds a seat when watches the couple who are dancing. Then all of a sudden, Alfie came to Haley. Asked her to dance with him when the music by Dan Hill with the title Never Thought That I Could Love played. Few hours later, the party was over. Friday. It was a winter evening. The wedding chapel was decorated with pure white flowers as white as the snowflakes falling in its winter. Naroon na si Alfie sa altar at naghihintay sa pagdating ni Haley habang lumalakad sa gitna ng aisle. He is so handsome in his wedding suit. He is wearing a dark blue suit. Haley is wearing a white with blue color motif wedding gown. The motif of her wedding gown is like the color of a clear blue sky. Dahan-dahang naglakad si Haley patungo sa altar. Alfie waits her patiently. As she begins to walk towards the altar, the wedding theme song is sung by the famous singer Town. The music which they danced during Alfie's party with the title Never Thought. Haley reached the altar. Nagsimula na ang seremonya ng kasal. Makatapos ang isang oras, the wedding ceremony was over. They are now husband and wife. After the wedding, Haley and Alfie lived together in Alfie's adoptive family in the mansion. Then Haley started to work in R&A Summit Holding as Alfie's secretary. Haley finds it hard to be Alfie's secretary for she don't even go to college. Pero dahil likas ang pagiging matalino at madaling matuto, ay madali naman siyang naturuan ni Alfie. Haley noticed that Alfie was changed after their wedding. He always uses power and authority over her just to make her obey him. He is too possessive and strict to Haley. Wala nang ibang magawa pa si Haley tungkol sa mga bagay na iyon. Palagi na lamang siyang sumusunod sa lahat ng gusto nito para lamang hindi sila magkaroon ng away. Alfie doesn't want to act like that towards Haley but that's the only way he can make Haley to stay in his life. Ngayon, nakasama niya na si Haley at nagbalik na ito sa kanyang buhay, hindi na nito hahayaan pang umalis itong muli. Mahal na mahal niya si Haley, kaya hindi niya kayang pakawalan ito. He always played dirty tricks to Haley so that Haley will have no choice but to stay. There are times that Haley gets so angry with him and wanted to go back to her life. Mas gusto pa niyang sumama at manirahan sa kanyang lola sa ibang bansa kaysa manirahan sa lugar na iyon. But Alfie is threatening her that if Haley will leave him, he will no longer fund Haley's father's company at hahayaan niya itong bumagsak at malugi. Haley admits that when Alfie married her, the company of her father got a lot of benefits. Her father's company also became stable financially. So whenever Alfie warned her like that, she just obey on whatever he wanted. Hindi niya gugustuhing mabunton ang sisi kung sakaling malugi muli ang kumpanya. Kaya ginagawa niya ang lahat ng ito at sinusunod na lang ang lahat ng utos ni Alfie. Bukod doon, nakatutulong din siya sa kanyang pamilya sa Asian country. Ang pamilya ni Aling Elsa ay namumuhay ng maayos sa ngayon. Seeing them in that kind of situation makes Haley feel so glad. Nasa loob na siya ng opisina at tinatapos ang mga gawaing inaata sa kanya ni Alfie. Pero masama ang kanyang pakiramdam. Nahihilo at parang umiikot ang kanyang paningin. She was not able to balance and she may fall over. Hindi rin niya nakain ang kanyang tanghalian dahil sa tuwing kakain siya ay parang pakiramdam niya ay nasusuka. Gusto niyang umuwi pero nasa board meeting pa si Alfie at magtatagal iyon. Hindi niya nakayang tiisin ang lahat. Nagdesisyon siyang umuwi at i-drive ang sasakyan ng mag-isa. Pero bago tuluyang makauwi ng bahay ay dumaan muna siya sa isang clinic para magpakonsulta tungkol sa nangyayari sa kanya. After having a check-up, the doctor asked Haley to buy some medicine. So on her way home, Haley stopped first in a nearby pharmacy to buy some medicine. The pharmacy was located on the corner of the street in the downtown, which is beside a traveling agency that serves tickets for those who wanted to travel in Asian country. After buying the medicine that the doctor prescribed to Haley, Haley walks towards her car that she parked in front of the traveling agency because there is no parking space in the front of the pharmacy. One of the employee from the traveling agency gave her flyers. Tinanggap niya iyon at binasa. Pumasok siya sa sasakyan at sinimulang mag-drive pa uwi ng bahay. Nang makarating siya sa mansyon, nagdiretso siya sa kanyang kwarto dahil sobrang nahihilo pa rin ang kanyang pakiramdam. Nararamdaman niyang kailangan niya ng kaunting pahinga. But before she goes to sleep, she gets the medicine that the doctor prescribed. When Haley gets the medicine, the flyers from the traveling agency fall on the floor. Haley just ignores it for she thinks that it is not important. She goes straight to bed after taking the medicine. Nakatulog siya ng ilang minuto. Tapos na ang meeting ni Alfie. Bumalik siya sa kanyang opisina at hinahanap si Haley pero wala ito roon. Alfie wonder where she is. Kaya nagdesisyon siya na itanong ito sa ilabang empleyado. The guard informed him that her wife leaves about 2 hours ago. Alfie tried to call Haley but she is not answering the phone. Alfie got a message from one of his friend containing some photo of Haley in front of a traveling agency. That message made Alfie panic, thinking that Haley was thinking of leaving him again. Naisip ni Alfie na baka bumili ito ng ticket mula sa agency iyon. At sa pag-iisip niyon ay sobra siyang nainis. Dahil Biyernes noon, he has next appointment after the board meeting, nagdesisyon na siyang umuwi ng bahay para siguruduhin na naroon ito sa bahay. He wants to know the truth whether Haley buy a ticket going back to Asian country or she just park her car in front of that building. Nang makauwi sa bahay ay nakita niya ang asawang natutulog sa kwarto. Napahinga siya ng malalim. Nawala ang agam-agam sa kanyang sarili. But Alfie got nervous when he saw the flyers on the floor. The flyers contain prices of tickets going to Asian countries. Naupo siya sa kama ng asawa. Too disappointed. Iniisip niya na aalis muli ito at siguro totoo ang sinabi ng kanyang kaibigan. Naiisip niya na talagang bumili ng ticket si Haley para iwan siyang muli. Maybe because they always misunderstand each other lately so she decided to leave him again. But Alfie won't allow that thing to happen. Haley was awake from a deep slumber. He felt that someone was sitting beside her. When she opened her eyes, she saw Alfie. When Alfie sees that Haley is awake, he begins confronting her about the flyers that he saw on the floor. What is this flyer all about? Alfie begins to ask Haley about it. It's just nothing, sagot ni Haley. Are you sure? It's just nothing or you are planning to leave me? Wika ng lalaki. What are you talking about? What do you mean? Tanong ni Haley kay Alfie. Confusion crosses on her lovely face. As if she knew that a piece of paper will make Alfie doubt her again, and she did not ignore it and show it instantly on the trash. Nalilimutan mo na ba ang mga sinabi ko sa'yo? Totoo iyon at gagawin ko yon. Dare to pack your things and get ready to go if you want to see your father in a problematic situation. Wika ni Alfie. While inside of him, he is shaking and all he wants is just to get down on his knees and beg Haley not to go. But he never dares to do that because Haley won't listen to him if he stops her from leaving in that way. It's much better to show her that he is angry so that she will stay. Sa gitna ng paghuhuramentado ni Alfie ay kinuha ni Haley ang papel sa kanyang bag upang ipakita rito kung bakit talaga naroroon siya sa lugar na iyon na nakitaan sa kanya. Pinakita niya rito ang kanyang medical result. But before she can give it to Alfie, she hears him talking again, raising his voice to her. Haley, do you hear me? Wika nito sa galit na ton. Nang mga sandaling iyon ay naiinis na din si Haley at gusto na nitong sumagot. Fine, you win. You've changed a lot. I hate you. Sigaw nito kay Alfie while throwing the papers that she is holding on Alfie's face. The papers fall on the floor. Then Haley rushed to get inside the bathroom and cried. Alfie didn't get the paper that Haley threw on his face. Hearing her words, Alfie felt too much emotional pain, but that pain is bearable, rather than the pain that will he cause when Haley walks out of his life again. Narinig ni Alfie ang pag-iyak ni Haley, showing anything that she throws and able to grab. Hearing Haley cries make him weak. Alfie take a deep breath and go onto the balcony of their room. Nanlalamig ang kanyang pakiramdam na lumapit sa balcony at nararamdaman niya ang malamig na simoy ng hangin. It's winter again. Isang taon na ang nakalilipas. Bukas ay kanila ng wedding anniversary but they are still fighting again. Alfie sat down on the floor of the balcony, leaning on the wall, allowing the snowflakes to fall over him. Ipinikit niya ang kanyang mga mata at hinayaang tumulo ang mga luha. Those tears that he held back with all his might so that he would not cry in front of Haley. He will not cry in front of Haley to show that he is weak. The little boy who can do nothing when she walked away and walked out in his life a long time ago. This time, it would be different. He will do everything just to make her stay because Haley is not just his friend now. They are husband and wife, so he has all the rights in doing so. But Alfie gets too surprised when he feels that there is someone touching his face and wiping his tears. Nang buksan niya ang kanyang mga mata, nakita niya si Haley na nakaupo sa harapan niya. Pinilit niyang i-compose ang kanyang sarili. What are you doing here? Don't touch me, sagot ni Alfie. Then he quickly removed the hands of Haley away from his face. Then he starts pretending that he is angry. But the truth is, he is just trying to hide the pain he felt inside. Ayaw niyang ipakita iyon kay Haley. I'm sorry, Alfie. I didn't mean it. Wika ni Haley. All right, sagot ng binata. Haley can see how far the look in his eyes. Alfie do that because he don't want to look in Haley's face. He don't want to talk to Haley. He don't want to make Haley cry again if he can say something that will hurt her feelings. Hinawakan ni Haley ang mga papel sa harapan na nilimot mula sa pagkakalaglag. Alfie read what the document is about. He saw that it is an ultrasound of a 6-week-old baby inside a mother's womb. Alfie feels so glad. It means that Haley is pregnant. Yon ang dahilan kung bakit umalis ito nang walang paalam at hindi na naintay pang matapos ang board meeting ni na Alfie. Nagtungo siya sa clinic. Alfie regret that he just gets angry easily when he finds out that Haley leaves the office early. Nagalit siya dahil hindi ito nagpaalam sa dahilang hindi niya alam. He let himself carried away by the thought that Haley is planning to leave him again. I will never leave you. I am pregnant. I won't make the same mistake that your mother did to your father. I will not let our child suffer the same thing that you suffered when you are young. I will not make the same mistake that my parents did. Give up on each other and leave each other without considering that they have a child that will be left abandoned. I don't want our child suffer the feelings of being abandoned and rejected, like what I felt when my parents got divorced. Paliwanag ni Haley. Sa pagkakarinig ng mga salitang iyon ay sobrang kasiyahan ang naramdaman ni Alfie. All he can say is that, thank you and finally Haley will stay. Thanks Haley, wika nito. The sweetest smile crossed in his face, revealing his pure white teeth. When he embraced Haley tight, Alfie can't believe his dream come true, that Haley choose to stay with him again. Pagkatapos ng lahat na kanilang pinagdaanan, they really meant to be forever. After that conversation, Alfie's attitude went back to normal because he is nothing to worry about. Haley didn't attempt to leave him anymore, and she promised to stay. The few months had passed. Alfie's grandfather, Hamilton, formally turned over his position to Alfie. Finally, Alfie becomes the executive chief officer of RNA Summit Holding. Dahil ang totoo, hindi maitatanggi na siya ang tunay na anak ni Alexander. He ran RNA Summit Holdings as the way his father did. Winters ended and springtime came. Haley gave birth to a son. Alfie can say that his life is so complete now that he had his own family that he is wishing for so long. After all, he is happy now, more than happy than ever.
Ang kwentong ito ay nagpapatunay na when love is truly right, it lives from year after year. It changes as it goes, but it will never disappear. Kung talagang kayo, kayo hanggang dulo. Lumipas man ang maraming panahon, walang magbabago sa nararamdaman para sa isa't isa.
Ang pagtatapos ng ating kwento. Maraming maraming salamat po sa patuloy na pagsama at pagsubaybay. Naway patuloy niyo pa kaming samahan sa mga paparating pa naming mga uploads. Muli, mag-ingat po tayong lahat.